welcome to the Jones Center here in Springdale, Arkansas, where your Arkansas Razorbacks get set to take on the DBU Patriots. Alongside me today is Corry Porter on color commentary. We got Matt Martens on camera, Loren McClain here producing, and my name is EJ Sanders. Having the call for you today, Arkansas came in last night and was able to shut out these DBU Patriots 3-0 on military night, and boy, it was a packed house last night. Glad to see a little bit less of a crowd tonight. If I'm being honest, it was a little crowded up top, but we're glad that everybody got out and was able to win raffles for those jerseys, Corry.
Yeah, still a packed crowd tonight, but not quite standing room only. Last night they were lining the boards, they were lining the back of the bleachers, but the bleachers are full, so expect a ruckus crowd here on this matinee game as Arkansas comes out and tries to make it a two-game weekend over these DBU Patriots.
Well, Arkansas moved to 20-2 last night, and they started Joseph Dusenko, who will get the rest tonight. It's going to be Sam Haynes in goal for the Arkansas Razorbacks. He's the primary backup. He's 5-0 on the season with a shutout and a 1.82 goals against average and a .921 save percentage. That's the best on the team with people with five or more starts, I should say, as Noah Goodwin has some good stats as well. On the other end, we expect it to be Randy Miller. If that changes, we'll let you know. But Randy Miller has been the tried and true for this team. He's 8-8-3 now, and he came into the weekend with a 3.82 goals against average and an .896 save percentage. Dallas Baptist moved to 9-11-3 after the loss last night to Arkansas. We'll see if they have a little bit of pep in their step in this first period.
Yeah, I'll say Randy Miller is probably the heart and soul of this DBU team as he does skate out onto the ice first, and we'll get the start tonight. Excellent in goal, really played well for them last night. Did give up the three goals, but a lot of that was just due to Arkansas' sustained pressure and really just put a lot of shots on goal and made it tough on him all night. And offensively for DBU, really not able to get much going. They'd come out hot in the first period, came out hot in the second period, but unable to turn that into goals. Also went 0-for-6 on the power play, something they'll look to capitalize on today if Arkansas continues to find themselves in the penalty box, as they have struggled with that quite a bit this season. So hopefully they look to clean that up a little bit this afternoon.
Well, a nice matinee game tonight. I should say today, as the sun's still shining through the windows. Causes a little glare on the ice, but, something we have to contend with here at the Jones Center. Arkansas, meanwhile, is looking forward to following up on that national championship runner-up that they had last season. They're currently introducing the DBU lineups over the loudspeaker, but Arkansas has a real chance to make a run. They're going to try to win the MACA their first year in it, and then after that, who knows? They scheduled a couple exhibition games against Oklahoma State here at the Jones Center after that. Not certain if we'll have those live for you yet, but we'll see how that plays out. And then after that, of course, is going to be the national tournament.
Yeah, and you mentioned last year's national championship runner-up, and Arkansas looking good again this season. The record looks good, and the rankings look good as well. The D3 rankings have come out, been updated a couple times, and Arkansas is number 3 in the most recent ranking. Behind number 1 Hope, who they lost to in the championship last year, as well as Grand Valley State. But Arkansas high up in those rankings and looking to stay there for the foreseeable future as we call out some of these starters and see a couple guys that are juniors and going to see a lot more ice time. Even the seniors have a chance to come back should they choose to do so due to the COVID rules.
Michael Ellis, Trevor McClain, and Kyle Cruz getting the start tonight. And like you said, that's two juniors and a freshman, Kyle Cruz. Listed as a freshman still, but he was here last year as well. Dylan Odeline and Kevin LaPlante out there, and of course Sam Haynes getting the start tonight for Arkansas. The Dallas, Texas native stands at 6'1", 155.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you please rise for the singing of our national anthem.
And we'll pause for a second for the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? His broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallant.
And we're ready for action here at the Jones Center. Dallas Baptist going to be skating from right to left in their blue uniforms, navy blue with the white shoulder yoke and the red trimming, the red pants and the blue socks. Meanwhile, Arkansas back to their normal home, white uniforms with the red trim, the red shoulder yoke, and the black pants with the white socks as well. Arkansas has done well so far this year, and ever since that loss to Missouri State, they haven't looked back.
Yeah, it's a tough loss at home. Really not something they do. If they lose, it's a game on the road where they've had to travel. But really at the Jones Center, the fans here are treated to wins more often than not. So a rare home loss against Missouri State. And as you mentioned, have not lost since then. And they'll look to continue that streak in this second game against DBU.
They got to go on the road up there to Jordan Valley Ice Park and take on that Missouri State Bears team. As we get set for puck drop here at the Jones Center, game two of the weekend set. Arkansas looking to sweep the Dallas Baptist Patriots. Hand in the air and the puck drops and Dallas Baptist wins the opening faceoff. They'll play it back to the near side. Now Canavan on the puck. Canavan turns the puck over. Ellis out front fires a shot off the side of the net. Picked up now behind the net by Canavan. Slaps along to the near side boards. Odeline pinches down. Cruz throws it back to the point, but just having to dump it in, Arkansas have to check up the offside. Far side corner now picked up there by Hunter Miller. To Canavan near side. He'll try to work it out of the zone. Barrett skates it out of the zone. Sorry, that was Beckett. Comes all the way down on goal, and Haynes makes his first stop of the game. 19:33 to go in the first period.
Yeah, Haynes a little bit less experienced than Joseph Dusenko. You'll see him cover those up quite a bit, whereas last night we saw Dusenko play those, come out, try to make passes, saw him come out at one point diving for a loose puck as well, but I think Haynes is going to play it a little bit safer.
Face off to the right of Haynes. Ellis wins this one back, has Odeline, who flips this one end over end back to the neutral zone, and giving chase is McClain. The speedy McClain has Cruz on the drop pass, but a nice defensive play there to knock that one clear to safety. Picked up here by Ellis. The hand pass ruled off. Back to the point now. This is LaPlante. LaPlante loads one up, passes one down, finds Ellis. Ellis off the heel of his stick, and Cruz has to field it there for Arkansas. Arkansas on the puck, turned over momentarily. Cruz turns it back into the zone. McClain giving chase into the corner. He's pressuring Hamilton, who's on the puck. Hamilton, bank pass, far side, finds Perez. Perez works it towards the blue line, held in there by McAtee, who came on a change, and that one's flipped up and out of play off a stick. 18:57 to go, first period.
A little back and forth action so far. No real scoring chances yet.
Face off to the right of Miller. Going to be Avery Smith to take it. He was really physical last night. Quick shot off the faceoff there. Arkansas gets it back. Far side of the ice, not able to get it away from the DBU player. Near side now, McAtee chasing after it. Dumps and chases. Far side board, Sugasawara. He's over there along with Wilson, who gets stood up hard by Miller. Sorry, Avery Smith. Back to the blue line here. McAtee down into the corner. Giving chase there is Estrada. Estrada. Back to the near side boards now, picked up by Fortner. Fortner trying to work it out of the zone. McAtee puts a hip check on him, and it comes down for an icing. McAtee a little out of his way to get that check on Fortner exiting the zone, but Arkansas able to beat it out for the icing.
We see McAtee on the ice there. Good job by Smith as well, pressuring McAtee at the point. You know he likes to work from there.
Face
and
off.
Avery Smith breaking that up.
Faceoff will come to the left of Randy Miller. This one's one back, picked up here. Back the other way comes Miller. Jackson Miller up the near side boards. Slap shot from the point. Rebound there. Sugasawara settled it down with the skate. Wheels down in the corner now. Stick handling down to below the goal line. Sends that one over to Estrada, who's going to field that puck along with Wilson. Wilson to Estrada. Back to Sugasawara. One-time opportunity shut down. Swept aside there by the defender. And Arkansas takes it back to center ice. McAtee on it, right back into the zone. Arkansas upping the pressure here as McAtee's shot is off a stick and out of play. Good play there by Dylan Hamilton, and Arkansas will have an offensive zone faceoff.
Yeah, DBU was trying to get a change but didn't get the puck far enough down the ice, and Arkansas quickly turned it around, brought it into the zone as McAtee tried to get a shot away, but as you mentioned, a good job by Hamilton to get the stick in the way, and that puck goes up and out of play.
Scherer, faceoff back, and this one's chipped through traffic. Bevers there trying to get the puck. He's offside, and they'll have to check that one up. Delayed offside here. Romero far side now for Arkansas. Romero stick handling, has a man near side, Yance. Yance is D partner tonight. And one of the only substitutions we've seen so far in the lineup is Reese out, Romero in. Arkansas has a lot of defensemen that they can rely on, able to keep them fresh throughout the season. Back pass here from Miller. Jackson Miller up the near side boards. Arkansas's got to be careful. Up ahead now is Anthony Blakely. Yance on the puck, though. Stick handles back behind the net. A converted forward, I learned that today from Coach Sims. Yance has had to come into his own as a defenseman. There's a shot there on Haynes. He's able to fight that one off, and here comes Valentini back the other way. On with Yassine, through traffic, onside, chip to Yassine. Now backdoor, Romero's shot right into the body, and it's saved down there by Miller. 17:04 to go in the first, and a good start here for the Hogs.
Yeah, Arkansas nearly offside on that play, but able to get the puck just ahead of it. But Arkansas did look out of sorts on that rush a little bit, able to get a shot away, but a good save by Miller, and he holds on for the whistle.
Faceoff will be to Miller's left. Arkansas has Motor, Patterson, and Borlas on the ice. It's the same line they ran last night. So the only substitution we've seen so far is Reese out for Romero. Arkansas is going basically with the same guys two nights in a row, though I haven't seen Bome out there just yet. Skating up the ice now, quick shot towards net, and Haynes has to make a nice save. Right to the body as well, but you know, when you haven't seen a whole lot of action in over a couple of months, it can get a little bit nerve-wracking out there, any shot coming your way. So good job by Haynes to make these early saves and see some pucks whistled right at him. 16:54 to go, first period of action. Faceoff one back, picked up here by Hunter Miller. His shot hits a man in front. It's passed back, a little back pass blindly in front, stolen away by Odeline across the red line. Blue line into the offensive zone, another shot gloved down there by Miller. Motor snows the goaltender a little bit. They're already getting after it in the corner. Motor came in a little hot.
Yeah, we saw some physical play last night. It kind of died down towards the end of the game, but definitely a lot of hitting early in that game and some pushing and shoving. Randy Miller, the goaltender, getting into it as well. I was wondering if we would see a bit more of that today. As I think if DBU can draw Arkansas into some of that, they may be able to draw a few penalties and try to take advantage like they were unable to do last night.
Face off to the left of Miller. This one's won back by Arkansas. Odeline on the puck, throws one towards the corner. It's going to be picked up here by Borlas. A back pass blindly in front, stolen away by DBU momentarily. Slammed off the boards there by Borlas and fielded nicely there by Buddy Barrett. Up the ice, back the other way comes Beckett. Christian Beckett, the leading goal scorer for the Patriots. It's going to be picked up on the near side now, Odeline. Odeline on the puck, far side now looking for Motor into the offensive zone. Big hit late on Odeline behind the play. Patterson olays a man and sends it into the corner. Picked up here by Miller, far side now, chipped off the boards there by Hill. Held in by Arkansas, shot tipped aside there by Borlas. Borlas, centering pass, had Motor in front. It's going to be picked up instead and cleared out of the zone by Austin Hill. 16:03 to go, first period, picked up here by McAtee. McAtee stick handling through traffic, near side boards now. Shot towards net, stick to side. Rebound was there, but steered aside nicely there by Fortin. All the way down the ice, no icing here. Avery Smith beats it out. Wheels a pass in front. It's knocked aside by Arkansas, down into the corner now, picked up there by Perez. Perez looking for a centering pass through traffic off the side of the net and picked up here by Arkansas. Ellis skates it out the other way. On the near side now, Ellis flips one end over end towards net, takes an awkward bounce, and Miller has to control that one. And Cruz comes in hot again, and he's going to be met by four DBU players, and they're going to take one of them.
Wow. Perez was arguing his case, and looks like he'll get a misconduct tacked on as well. I said DBU needs to try to draw Arkansas into some of that chippiness, but instead it's DBU that draws the first penalty of the game, and Arkansas will go on the power play.
Two minutes for roughing and a 10-minute misconduct here. They'll have to put somebody in the box. Looks like to serve that penalty will be Loudon Harris, who did not play yesterday. So Arkansas on the power play, like you were saying, Corey. They have a face-off to the left of Miller. It's going to be picked up here by McAtee at the point. McAtee has a man far side. They like to run four forwards for their power play unit, and they've got him on the ice right now. McAtee at the point, stick handling here, has Ellis in front, sends it down to Sugasawara below the goal line near side, back to the point, finds McAtee. McAtee far side, now Wilson. Zach Wilson, the captain on the puck, fires a shot, and that one's saved down by Miller. That one was going wide, but Miller wants to get the quick freeze, make sure that those legs stay fresh.
Yeah, good job there too, because DBU can win a faceoff and try to get this puck out of the zone. Arkansas sets up really well on the power play. They really try to run it through Cam McAtee at the point. And they'll look to do that again here. Yeah,
face-off one back to McAtee. Little bank pass finds Wilson. He has to settle it down, and he gets tripped up there. No call. Wow. Boy, stick the skates. A shot on goal there. I think Arkansas, that might have been a little bit of a makeup there from the referee. I don't know if he saw it through all the traffic, but McAtee skating ahead all on his own through traffic. McAtee working his way through traffic. He gets slashed off the puck. I think DBU is daring the referee to make a call right now. That was a clear trip on McAtee the first time around. I'm not certain what happened there that stood McAtee up, but Arkansas comes back the other way. Here's Estrada. He's got Wilson behind him. Estrada back to the point. McAtee loads one up. High circle shot wide of the net. Picked up by Wilson far side. Comes skittering to a halt. Picked up here. Now Ellis. Ellis on the puck. Outer hash. Far circle. He'll load up a shot and score! Michael Ellis! And Arkansas notches a power play goal to get the scoring open.
Just a nice shot from the faceoff dot. Gets the puck in the corner, skates out. And it looked like Beckett was trying to get over to him, but just a half step late, and a great shot by Ellis beats Randy Miller. And just like last night, Arkansas's on the board first here in the first period, and that one does go down as a power play goal.
Center ice faceoff now. Got to take the penalty off the board here, and Fabian Perez will serve another 8 or 10 minutes here before he's able to get out of the box. This one shot down towards the corner, picked up here by Odeline. The ensuing faceoff after the goal for Arkansas, 1-0. Arkansas leads. This takes an awkward bounce out front off the skate of McClain. Cruz cleans it up nicely, near side boards now. That one hit the door. Took an awkward bounce, and there's Bome, who I think is the extra forward today for Arkansas. Into the zone. Skating with it there is Hill. Hill loses the puck. Arkansas lifts it back to center ice, and they'll field it here now. A little back-and-forth action. As Bome's on the puck near side, he absorbs a big hit there. Picked up in the corner there by Bratton. Far side now, held in there by LaPlante. Backhand pass finds Cruz. Cruz has a man in the near side point. Opts to take it himself. High slot shot fired high and wide. Picked up here by McClain. Below the goal line, outer hash, far side. That's Cruz. His shot through traffic is stymied, and Bratton lifts it in the air, and a high stick play down there by Odeline. It's just dumped into the zone, and Arkansas gets away with one there. Trying to hit the home run ball, DBU. We saw him try to do it a couple of times last night, and Dusenka came out and made a flying save at one point late in the game to preserve the shutout and was able to keep the Patriots scoreless the rest of the time. Back the other way. Into the zone comes Fortner. He goes stumbling to the ice with a little help from an Arkansas defender. On it there is now Hunter Miller, far side. He's got a man. Loaded up there is Canavan, and he'll send that one up and out of play. Like it hit a stick on the bench, and we'll have a stoppage and an offensive zone faceoff for the Razorbacks.
That's now four goals on the weekend for the Razorbacks, scored by four different players. We mentioned the depth of DBU and the scoring across the board, but Arkansas is the team that has shown that scoring depth this weekend.
Yeah, absolutely. We were talking about we want to see more scoring depth out of Arkansas. They got, you know, three of the guys who are in the top 10 in the nation in scoring, and from there it's slim pickings. They are getting production from their lower guys tonight as there's a rebound coming out front into the skates of Scherer. He couldn't quite corral that one. Far side now, Crawford out of the zone. He'll back pass this one along. Back and forth finally down the ice. Scherer, after it has a man in his hip pocket, has to hustle after it. McAtee fields it now near side. Out of the zone from his own faceoff dot. This one's stolen away. Into the offensive zone comes Noah Ledbetter. His shot is blockered aside. Nice save there by Haynes. And this one centered back out front. Haynes paddles it aside and is picked up by Yassine. Arkansas back the other way, a 3-on-2 if they hustle. Here comes Yassine, powers by one man. Yassine, a centering pass, and is steered aside there by Canavan. Far side now, Valentini on the puck. That one's sticked away there, and Hamilton's trying to work it out of the zone. Glove down there by Arkansas, but Ledbetter's on it again. Right-handed stick fires towards the back post. That's a tough angle to try and hit. He just missed the net wide. Near side boards now picked up here by Canavan. Canavan loads one up, tipped in front, just wide of the net there by Blakely. Far side now, Ledbetter on it. Arkansas able to steal it away from him, and Patterson skates freely with it. 2-on-2, back the other way. Patterson far side of the ice, right-handed stick into the slot, fires it off the crossbar and out of play. I think that one hit the corner of the post. An excellent opportunity for the Hogs, and it goes begging.
Yeah, nice 2-on-2 opportunity as you see Borlas going wide. But Patterson makes a nice move. just off the corner of the post, as you called. Tough break for the Hogs, but they'll get an offensive zone faceoff.
Patterson's shown a lot of pep in his step this weekend as well. A lot of guys out here vying to try to make the lineup every single week, and it's tough to do, and you got to put on performances like that if you want to be out there. Shot there by Motors, kicked the side by Miller, far side now, trying to power it out of the zone is Austin Hill. Arkansas turns him away. Another exit attempt is stolen away by Johnson. Quick pass down to Borlas. It's too hot. Borlas, nice deke between the defender's legs, picked up here by Motor. He's fighting for it, looking for Borlas, who gets caught up in the referee there. Borlas hustling back, puts a shoulder check on as this comes all the way down for an icing. 11:06 to go, first period of action. Arkansas with the early tally by Michael Ellis on the power play.
That took them 15 minutes before they got their first goal last night. Able to get their first goal within the first half of the period in today's game.
Well, that's been Arkansas's MO all season. They love to score early, and we mean early, early. Most of the time within the first 5 minutes of the game, they try to get on the board, and sometimes twice we've seen them do it. But last night, a really slow start, probably a little lethargy out of the Christmas break. This one stick back into the zone and offside. Odeline arguing, and he's going to go to the box. Technical penalty here.
Looks like the referee, Chip Excel, is not going to take any jawing today. We see examples from both teams trying to get it under control early. As Odeline better be careful. Doesn't get any more minutes tacked on. And DBU will have their first power play of the game. As I mentioned, 0-for-6 last night, but they were able to get set up when they're able to get control of the puck, but Arkansas's got an excellent penalty kill, plays well on the shorthand, on the offensive end as well. A lot of shorthanded goals, and LaPlante's got to be careful there. Took a little bump, and
a lot going on. A shot to the bench. That one did hit a player on the bench. Yeah, and the referee's saying, hey, you know, LaPlante took a shot on his way to the bench and gave one back.
Yep.
10:48 to go. There is definitely some three teams on the ice right now. We'll see if the neutral team is able to settle this game down. This one sent all the way down. Miller well out of his net. Has to play it to the near side boards and out of the zone. Here comes DBU. Avery Smith on the puck. He absorbs a big hip check. Far side now. Wilson into the zone. Wilson on the puck. There's going to be an elbowing here, and Arkansas is going to get the extra attacker on. It'll be 5-on-5 momentarily. 1:33 to go in the Odeline penalty for jawing at the ref. Back behind the boards. Deskier on it now. Elbowing penalty against Sugasawara. Arkansas just doesn't need to put it in their own net, and they don't. And that one's finally touched up.
They finally do touch up. I was wondering if they shouldn't let DBU touch it up earlier and get that 5-on-3 opportunity for a little bit longer.
I think the referee took that hard slapper on the touch up there. And he talks it out with the guy and make sure that they're all right. So we'll have 4-on-4 action for a minute 20. Arkansas will have a 40-second power play after that. Face-off one back here by DBU. It's going to be Canavan on the puck near side, back behind his own cage now. Canavan on it, looking to work it out of the zone. 4-on-4 action right now. Down the ice on goal, and Haynes is just going to cover that one up. They want to hit Beckett with that home run ball, and it makes you wonder how many of those 20 goals he's scored doing just that.
That's an effective play at times, but really not one you want to have to rely on.
Well, the ice a lot shorter here. Talk about it a lot, but it's a lot shorter here at the Jones Center. And so that play doesn't often result in maybe the desired outcome as McAtee pinches up on the play, but gets it taken off his stick there by Barrett. He'll wheel it back into the corner. Arkansas on it. Outlet pass. Ellis right to the tape of Estrada. On the back door, his shot is blockered aside. Miller cuts down the angle. Came way out of the crease to make that save, and now Barrett's on the puck. Barrett has Beckett streaking towards the zone. Barrett stick handling, right-handed stick, drop pass, has a man, shot, flutters over the goal. It's going to be stick to side there by Desquier. Desquier has a man, far side now, Estrada, looking for the puck, back pass, finds McAtee in the corner. 36 seconds left in the 4-on-4, 9:26 to go in the period. On the puck now is McAtee. McAtee, outlet pass, far side, finds Estrada. Estrada, stick handling, gets it all the way back to Haynes. He'll have to settle it down here. Haynes, weakly to the near side, Desquier on it now. He's on his backhand, lays a pass off, and here comes McAtee. The one-man offense through the offensive zone into the DBU territory. Tries to back pass one along. Ellis not ready for that one. It's a turnover. Far side now. It's going to be picked up by Arturo Garcia. He'll send it back to the near side. Arkansas, nobody home on Christian Beckett. LaPlante's got to steer himself to the near side as the penalty expires on Odeline. Arkansas gets a man off the ice. Odeline right up on the rush immediately. 2-on-1 the other way. Ellis in the zone. Fires one, and it's blocker to side again by Miller. Able to get that stick save as another shot by LaPlante sneaks through traffic. Rebound still there. It's chopped aside there by Hunter Miller. Far side now, Odeline. Odeline stick handling. Wheels a pass along, but going off for a change was Ellis. As that one hits another player on the bench, we'll have another stoppage. 17 seconds left in the power play here for Arkansas. 8:29 left in the first period.
A lot of back and forth action. DBU had a power play that turned into a 4-on-4. That happened twice last night as well. And now they're down a man for the next 17 seconds.
Face off one back by Arkansas. Odeline on the puck. Near side now has LaPlante looking for a man in the middle. Opts for a bank pass. Near side boards. Valentini, Scherer. Scherer, Valentini, down below the circle. 5 seconds to go in the power play. Laid back off, here's Scherer. Scherer on the puck. Tries to lay one back into the zone and held in there by Scherer. Scherer, outer hash, leaves one there for Odeline. Whips a shot towards net, blocked down nicely in front by Hill. Arkansas, 5-on-5 now. Sent back down the ice, and this one's going to come down for an icing. Trying to hop over the boards there was Derek Bratton, but he's not going to get off. 8 minutes to go in the first.
I'm not sure he was aware that the penalty had expired. And he'll have to come back out onto the ice.
Letting that song play, it'd be nice to have a copyright strike from Cotton Eye Joe. As Odeline shots whistled toward the nets, picked up near side boards. Now Bratton. Bratton works it towards the blue line. Odeline chips it back into the zone, into the skates of a defender, and Cruz tries to settle it down. LaPlante now on it. Slapper towards net, blocked aside there by Hill. Down into the corner, Bratton meets the force of Valentini's hit, and it's sent to the near side. Now Cruz. Cruz back to Odeline. One-timer tipped in front and scored! Scherer out of the air, and Arkansas on the board! 7:35 to go in the first period. Arkansas 2, DBU nothing.
Arkansas able to get the puck back to Odeline at the point. He actually breaks his stick on this shot, and that's why it goes so weakly. And Scherer, just a heads-up play, sees it out in front, sitting in the slot, able to redirect it into the net. And Arkansas leads this one 2-0 on the goal from Jake Scherer.
A knuckler right to the center of the ice, end over end, and it found the stick of Jake Scherer, who batted it out of the air through the five hole of Randy Miller. Nothing you can do about that. Quick redirection. Back the other way quickly, though, are the Patriots. Into the zone. Quick shot there wide of the net. Haynes got to be right ready for some more action on this end. DBU is going to pick up the pressure in this first period. Outlet pass blocked aside. Back to the center of the ice. Fortner on it. Gets sticked off there by McAtee. McAtee loads up a stick check. Can't get the better of it, though. And DBU still with possession. Finally knocked away by Arkansas and shut down there. And back the other way comes Bome. That one trickled past him and picked up by Canavan in the defensive zone for the Patriots. Canavan for DBU gets pressured there by Bome. McClain chips it around him. McClain centering pass has a man out front. Wrong stick there's Yassine. Left-handed stick might have a better opportunity at it. This one's wheeled back along, far side now. That's Bome down in the far side corner offensive zone for Arkansas. Now DBU works it out. Back to the blue line. Stopped there momentarily by Arkansas as the puck comes back to the Arkansas zone. McAtee far side. Yassine doesn't see it. It's finally chopped away and into the zone. It's going to be picked up here by the goaltender Miller. Sends one near side. Bank pass looking for Canavan. Arkansas pressuring the play. A big hit laid on the far side boards. Arkansas has got to be careful, but it looks like the referee is blocked off from the play. Outlet pass, finds his man, back to the neutral zone. Now Arkansas in their own zone, and it's going to be a delayed penalty here on Yassine. 6:15 to go, first period. Arkansas going back to the penalty kill. And DBU didn't score last night at all, but they had multiple opportunities on the power play. And they did look dangerous a couple of times as well, so Arkansas's got to stop taking these penalties.
Yeah, they were able to move the puck, but they didn't get a whole lot of shots. I want to see them win this faceoff, move the puck quite a bit, and get a quick shot away. Try to put some pressure on this young goaltender for Arkansas.
Faceoff one back here. LaPlante banks one off the far side's boards. Arkansas looking for the puck. Near side now. It's going to be picked up here by Beckett. Beckett far side now. Settled down by Blakely. Blakely chip pass along, has his man. Canavan wheels one back around into the corners, picked up here by Barrett. Barrett to Blakely. Canavan, Blakely, high circle now. He'll fire a shot. It's blocked down there by LaPlante. Whistle back in front, and Arkansas holds on to it. This is Sugasawara, far side now, Wilson. Wilson breaking out of the zone. Wilson stick handling through traffic down to the curling dot in the offensive zone and just sends it back to his own end smartly. Odeline, weak pass across, and then batted back across by LaPlante for Odeline to send all the way down. Sauce that one to the other end. It's an amazing amount of power that he has with just a flick of the wrist. This one sent back into the neutral zone. Now Sugasawara banks one along, a little spin move, look, going after the puck. Blakely shuts that play down. Now Wilson on the puck for Arkansas. Wilson gets it knocked off his stick, and it's a 3-on-3 the other way. And Sugasawara back checks hard. Barrett was on the puck there momentarily. Arkansas takes it away from him. LaPlante pinning his man against the boards, far side. Barrett, a couple others, and it looks like a guy was on top of the puck, so they'll call that one frozen. 48 seconds left in the Yassine Minor. Out of the box now also is Fabian Perez, who served his 10-minute misconduct.
Yeah, I think that whistle was going to blow either way, either a frozen puck or an offside if DBU eventually touched it in the zone, as there was a player down on the ice and the puck was sitting just outside the zone, but we get a face-off right outside Arkansas's end.
One back here by McAtee. McAtee to the near side, banked all the way down the ice, and that's an icing. Guess they waved that one off. Oh, on the penalty kill, of course. Arkansas on the back check now as this one's batted into the zone. Far side boards picked up here by Hunter Miller. Far side corner, upended there was Deskier back to the point. Has a man shot through traffic, tipped down in front and just wide of the net. Arkansas looking for the puck. On it now is Fortner. Fortner far side Miller. Hunter Miller gets slammed into the boards by Deskier. Not like him to have that kind of physicality to Deskier, but a good job stepping up on that play. That one's taken out of the hands. I think Ellis is going to get called with a slash. Came right over top of the hands of Hunter Miller, and Arkansas is going to be down two men for 8 seconds. 4:23 to go, first period. So Arkansas 5-on-3 for 8 seconds here. 4:23 to go in the period. Arkansas's got Sugasawara, McAtee, and Deskier out there. This one's one back to Deskier. He'll just stick handle, try to kill off some of that penalty, and he'll send it down the ice. It's going to be back to 5-on-4 now. Back up the near side boards. Out of the zone, here comes Hamilton. Hamilton gets stopped down there by Sugasawara. Far side now. In their own zone, Canavan turns it back, left-handed stick, sends it to the near side, nobody home. Having to chase after it, there's Christian Beckett. Beckett far side now, and they can't get anything going. DBU a little bit discombobulated on that first rush, and Arkansas steals it away easily. Sent nicely down the ice there by McAtee, slaps one along. Miller comes out to stop that puck. Canavan on it, Scherer pressuring him. Weakly to the near side again, out of the zone. This is going to be Avery Smith on the puck. He gets stood up by Odeline, and LaPlante comes away with it. Nice backhand towards the blue line and out of the zone, able to lift that one all the way down the ice. Picked up here by Bratton. Bratton back skating back behind his own net below the goal line. Far side now, Canavan. Canavan, bank pass, far side, looking for Smith, who makes a nice move, 2-on-1 into the offensive zone. Has a man back post, fires a shot, and Haynes makes the save. Haynes has been good so far, and Arkansas needs him to make some big saves in the early going.
Yeah, 2-on-1 develops here as Odeline's the lone man back, and he does a good job taking the pass and allows Sam Haynes to take the shooter, and he does his job making the save, and good on him for not giving up the rebound either.
Face off one back there by Valentini. Lifted easily end over end down the ice. This one's up on an edge still and finally comes to a halt. Behind the net, it's going to be Beckett on the puck. Beckett having to avoid McClain. McClain near side has Odeline. Odeline loads one up. He's at the point, just throws it through traffic, tipped in front. Valentini got a stick on it. Nice save by Randy Miller. Back the other way comes Buddy Barrett. He gets stood up there at center ice, and now McClain plays one back to Odeline. Odeline all the way down again. This one sent along the near side boards towards the blue line. Picked up there by Beckett. Sent back to the far side boards. LaPlante chops at the puck and finds Valentini in the neutral zone. Valentini a one-on-five the other way. Fires a shot. Nice save. Rebound comes all the way back to the high slot. Stolen away here by McClain. Stick handles through traffic. Nice job taking it off his stick there by Barrett. Goes back to his man in the D zone, and Miller plays it out to Barrett. Barrett stood up there by Romero. Barrett bodies that one along and gets stood up again by Romero. Back the other way, and they're going to call a penalty here.
Nah, I think he just lost his helmet, so trying to keep the player safe as Barrett was kind of trying to go low to avoid that hit, but Romero laid the hit on, and Barrett's helmet came off, so the referee wisely blows the whistle so he can get his lid back on.
Romero almost took two helmets off there as Beckett is readjusting his as well. Romero, we talked about it beforehand, an interesting pairing with Jantz out there. Jantz, much more a stick-checking type of defenseman, type of guy who's going to get back, skate back, and do a lot of back-checking. Romero, meanwhile, he'll step up and hit you, regardless of the consequences. And there's Jantz stepping up and hitting somebody. So there you go. 2:08 to go here in the period. Arkansas plays this one back to the neutral zone. Five-on-five action right now. Far side of the ice, banked along, tipped up and out of play there by Motor. Nope, stays in play, went straight up right near the boards. Looked like it was going to find its way out of the ice arena. It's going to be picked up on the far side now. Garcia on the puck. It's shut down there by Borlas. This is a frustrating line on the ice. Arkansas has this line out there quite a bit. And it's Borlas, Patterson, and Motor, and they are quite the energy line. This is sent to the near side. Romero stops the play there. Romero absorbs a check. Romero still on the puck. Sends one down along the boards into the near side corner offensive zone for Arkansas. Finally picked up by Hunter Miller for DBU. Patriots on the puck. Whiffing on one there is Jantz. He's going to have to hustle back. One-on-one into the zone. Beckett on the puck. Beckett stick handling through traffic. Jantz gets back, makes a check. Centering pass blocked down there and a good back check by Arkansas. Jantz stands two guys up. He comes out of there with the puck. He'll send one to Borlas. Outlet pass. Jantz goes for a change. Arkansas on the puck. Romero with it. Tries to pass one ahead looking for Patterson. Laid off here by Haynes, and now McAtee's on it for Arkansas. The All-American with 1 minute to go. Motor tips this one into the zone. Arkansas going to get their top line out there. Their starters, I should say. Ellis on the ice. Deskier near side. Now it's going to be picked up by Blakely into the zone. Blakely dumps one in, chasing down on the far side corners Bevers. Everett Bevers stood up by Ellis. Ellis putting a little extra on that hit as Bome comes away with the puck. Brendan Bome is skating ahead. Gets stick checked from behind there by Ledbetter. Sent back to the neutral zone, but it's on McAtee's stick now. He's got four guys to contend with. Opts to just throw it deep into the zone. 28 seconds to go in the first period. Picked up here, far side of the ice. Canavan off the boards, held in here by McAtee. He tries to hold the line, does not. Arkansas has to check up, and they're going to say it was touched offside. 19 seconds to go, first period of action. Arkansas clinging to the two-goal lead.
Physicality has picked up here late in the first period. I was watching Borlas and Barrett in front of the net pushing and shoving, and then they finally met up again in the corner, and Borlas, I think, got a stick up high under the chin of Barrett as Barrett skated gingerly to the DBU bench and threw a stick holding his neck, but hopefully we see him out there again soon.
Face off one back here to McAtee. McAtee able to play this one ahead, and Bome plays it along for Cruz. Back high into the air, McAtee sticks it down to himself. Sorry, gloved it down to himself. Into the zone, 12 seconds to go. A shoulder save there by Haynes. Flashy at the end of the period. 9.5 seconds to go.
Well, got to stay alert there, Haynes. That one might have gone high, but came right at his chest. Quick reaction makes the save.
Faceoff will be to his right, so that's where the shot came from. Arkansas going to look to kill off the rest of this period with this defensive zone faceoff. It's one ahead instead, and here comes Cruz. Cruz out of the zone, 6 seconds to go. Chips a puck past the defender into the offensive zone, and he gets knocked away there. Canavan just going to tie it up in the corner, and that will end the first period of action. Another hard-fought period for the Arkansas Razorbacks, and a lot to talk about if you're Coach Sims in the locker room, mainly staying out of the penalty box.
Yeah, I think that's a theme for Arkansas all year long, just unnecessary penalties. Some of them are within the flow of the game, but some are for running their mouths, and others are for slashing the stick out of your hands. And, you know, they just got to try to clean that up. Luckily, DBU hasn't been able to capitalize on any of the numerous power plays they've had either yesterday or today, but you know, one day it's going to happen, whether it's today or whether it's in the future when these games matter a little bit more in postseason play. But Arkansas has definitely got to try to clean up those penalties.
Yeah, a couple of misconducts we've seen already in this game. I think a good move by the referee to get the game under control early and make sure that it doesn't get out of hand. But Arkansas able to put two goals on the board, and it started with Michael Ellis earlier in the period. We'll go over those. He opened the scoring, and then the tip in by Scherer later in the period to make it 2-0. And that's where we'll stand going into this first intermission. Your Arkansas Razorbacks leading by a score of 2-0. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back in about 12 minutes for the start of the second period. Welcome back to the Jones Center here in Springdale, Arkansas, where your Arkansas Razorbacks lead by a score of 2-0. Alongside me is Matt Martens, Loren McClain, Corry Porter. My name's EJ Sanders. And boy, it was kind of another slow starter starting to look that way until there was a penalty there in the first period to Fabian Perez. He took a misconduct on top of that, and Arkansas was able to open the scoring with a goal from Michael Ellis. Arkansas was able to open the scoring with a goal from Michael Ellis.
There we go. We can see that goal. Ellis picks it up in the corner. Steps right out front, and a nice shot there. Puts Arkansas up 1-0 at that point. And then just a little later in the period, Arkansas able to get their second goal. On a goal from Jake Scherer. Ended up being a shot from the point. Dylan Odeline gets the pass. He actually breaks his stick on the shot, and it just flutters right out in front. And Scherer, watching it the whole way, able to get that redirection. Good hand-eye coordination.
From there, the rest of the period went scoreless between the two teams, and that's where we stand, 2-0, Arkansas currently leading the Dallas Baptist University Patriots. Arkansas has yet to drop a game all time against these Patriots. They're 15-0. Arkansas also this season is 20-0 when scoring at least three goals. We talked about this last night. And they are 0-2 when scoring fewer than three goals. So they got to get to that magic number here in the second period.
Yeah, sounds like they do. And it started much like yesterday's game, put up two in that first period, able to get the third goal about halfway through the second period, but then no scoring from then on. So, you know, Arkansas is going to try to put a few more goals in the back of the net, but they're going to have to contend with this DBU team who seems content to come out and play physical in this second game of this weekend. Still no goals to show for it, but not for lack of effort. Randy Miller in goal for the Patriots has looked good once again, but just facing a lot of pressure from Arkansas and DBU. Unable to get a whole lot going in the offensive end. Arkansas's zone entry defense has been really excellent as DBU is not able to get set up. Arkansas has been to the penalty box quite a bit, but again, the penalty kill has looked good tonight as well.
Well, Arkansas has done a good job of rolling four lines, and it keeps them nice and fresh throughout the game, whereas it seems like DBU only rolls about three lines, two and a half, really. They like to keep their top two scoring lines out there as much as they can, and then you can see how that wears on them throughout the game. Eventually, in the third period last night, it felt like DBU was just out of gas and just a lot of icings, a lot of things that you would see a team that is tired doing. But we'll see if they can keep the energy up and keep themselves in this game. They know that they have a good goaltender on this end of the ice, and Randy Miller's kept them in games in the past.
Yeah, he sure has, and I can't say enough about Arkansas trying to stay out of the penalty box. DBU does a good job drawing those penalties, and they look good early on in the power plays when they're able to win the faceoff in the offensive zone. They get it set up, but I think they're waiting just a little bit too long to try to get those shots off and eventually make an errant pass, and from there Arkansas just takes over. That zone entry defense, as I mentioned, really prevents DBU from getting set up once again. So if they can win those faceoffs on the power play and get set up and get those shots taken, you know, they have a chance to put up some goals, but got to try to score even strength as well, and they've been unable to do that against Arkansas.
20 minutes on the board, 2-0 Arkansas leads, and they win the ensuing faceoff here, the opening faceoff of the second period. Bank pass, far side, Odeline back to his D-to-D pass here. LaPlante trying to control it. Sends it to the near side board. Stolen away here by Hunter Miller. His shot off the stick of Barrett to the corner. Near side now. It's going to be Sugasawara. Outlet pass. Finds Wilson. He skates around one man into the offensive zone. Drop pass. Odeline shot saved down there by Miller. Just 23 seconds gone. It looked like DBU had a quick opportunity there, but Arkansas turned it into a chance of their own.
Yeah, slick little drop pass from Wilson. Finds Odeline and a nice wrist shot from the point. Puts it right into the belly of Randy Miller, and a good job to hold on and not give up a rebound.
Ensuing faceoff, one back here. That's going to be Odeline, who took too long, and a nice play there by Beckett to knock it into the defensive zone of Arkansas. Sent back around to the near side. A blind pass hits the stick of Estrada, kind of handcuffed him there, and he'll pick up the puck. Estrada back behind the cage. Estrada below the goal line, now out to the circle. Near side boards out of the defensive zone, finds a man far side. Odeline dumps it in. Comes up on an edge to the near side. Finally picked up here by Wilson. He shields a man off, but a nice hit there laid on by Hunter Miller. Puck still loose in the corner. Finally coming away with it there is Barrett. Barrett turning move. Right-handed stick sends one to the far side of the ice. On the outer hashes there. Beckett not able to get it out of the zone. Sugasawara quick cut to the middle. Not able to get anything of it, though. Finally, Sugasawara on the puck. Bank pass back to the point. Finds LaPlante. Sent hard around the boards. Far side, or near side, I should say. Picked up here by Wilson. Wilson, high circle. Long pass across. Finds McAtee just onto the ice. Rebound here on the near side. LaPlante throws a tough angled shot. Rebound there. Estrada shot blocked down in front by Canavan. Comes trickling to the side of the net. As DBU tries to play keep away behind their own net, Arkansas able to stop the rush, and that one just tickles the netting up top, and we'll have a stoppage. 18:27 to go, second period.
Good puck movement by Arkansas in the offensive zone. Nice cross-ice pass right to the tape of McAtee. Got the shot away, but another good save by Miller, and Arkansas stymied on the second chance opportunity.
Faceoff will be to the left of Miller. This one's going to be tied up and finally won ahead here by DBU. Sent all the way down the ice. No icing here as stepping out to make the play on the puck is Haynes. On it now is McAtee. Throws a pass near side. Bank pass along the boards just out of the outstretched stick of Ellis, and he loses the race with Avery Smith. Avery Smith, a little pep in his step as they talk it out. Those are always fun. You have to race a guy to the puck, and sometimes he just beats you. Get a little tap on the skates, get back on defense, and get ready to go for the faceoff. Ellis against Smith. And Ellis gets the better of him this time. Far side now. This is going to be Cruz on the puck. Bank pass along. He's stopped there by Bratton. Now picked up here by Arkansas. Defensive zone to Skier. Stick handling through traffic. Shields a man off and loses the puck in the neutral zone. Picked up here by Hamilton. Far side, Hamilton. Near side pass looking for Fortner, and they're going to blow that one dead. Or an icing.
Just an errant pass. Fortner was all alone streaking up that right side, but that pass well ahead of him. And it'll go for the icing. Tough break for the Patriots.
They'll send the faceoff to the far side. Ellis to take it against Smith again. And Ellis able to win that faceoff ahead. Smith on the puck. Arkansas able to take it away. This is McAtee on it. He's on his backhand right now. Trying to stick handle through traffic. Absorbs a hit. Sent around the boards. Ellis to McClain. Back to Ellis. A blind pass. Missed the stick of Ellis, but he picks it off. Ellis on it again. High circle near side. In the offensive zone. Loses the puck. Has to get back. Nice job by Ellis to stop the rush. Just onside is Smith. He'll throw a shot. Saved by Haynes. A quick glove there by Haynes to nab it out of the air. And with 2.5 minutes gone, this period is slogging along. A lot of stoppages here early. Face off to the left of Haynes.
Nice glove save there by Haynes, wearing it on that right hand.
Face off one back here by Arkansas. Yontz in the corner. Bank pass along, looking for Romero, who was not ready for that pass. You see now far side. Glides after it. He's just going to pin it along the board, send it hard and out of play. That one hit one of the leaning DBU players. A lot of Arkansas players leaning up on the boards as well. Bunch of guys ready to get back in on the action. 17:15 to go, second period. Everybody looks engaged in the game right now. Not a lot of sitting on the bench as this quick shot is kicked aside there by Haynes. Hasn't had to do a whole lot to this point, but that was a nice kick save. Down in the corner now, Yontz. Yontz. Back pass to himself, stopping move now below the goal line. Defensive zone gets it stolen away from him. Centering pass is broken up here by Scherer. He tries to power it past the defender, but he's stoned there by Blakely. Far side now, Romero on it. Romero lifts one into the air back to center ice. It's gloved down by Canavan. He has to dump and chase. DBU checked up the offside just in time. Yontz, a back pass, finds his man Romero. Romero looking to get it out of the zone. Arkansas having trouble doing so right now, and they got to get the delayed offside cleared again. DBU just keeps slapping it back into the zone. Far side, Romero can't do anything with it right now. Arkansas working hard up that right side to get it out of the zone, and they do. Romero giving chase in the hip pocket of Ledbetter. Ledbetter sheltering his man to the boards, and after it there is Scherer. Scherer along with his man as this one's flipped up towards the net. Arkansas comes away with it. Scherer on the puck momentarily and couldn't slap it back in front. Picked up here by Jackson Miller. Outlet pass finds Austin Hill. Hill dumps it into the zone, paddled aside there by Haynes. Into the corner, and a big hit laid on there by Odeline. Odeline almost a blindside hit there, has to be careful. Far side now, it's kicked along there by Barrett. Barrett, centering pass shot, goes in the net. I think that hit another DBU player in front. But the initial shot taken by Austin Hill, and it's 2-1.
And DBU gets their first goal of the weekend. Shutout yesterday. Sam Haynes was working on a shutout through the first period and about 4 minutes of this second period as well. But DBU steps out. Nice toe drag move. And then just throws it right back out in front to the stick. And a good goal there from DBU.
Well, that'll re-energize this DBU team. They're right back in the game now as they get the proximate goal. Into the zone now, it's going to be Smith. Avery Smith throws another shot towards net, blocked down there by Odeline, and it clears the zone. Bratton on it now, backhand pass near side. Arkansas able to corral it. Patterson on it, far side, tipped ahead there by Borlas into the offensive zone. No icing here, down after it's Hunter Miller. Hard around the boards, near side. Motor looking for any back checkers, and he comes away with the puck. Motor skates it along to himself, finds Borlas. Centering pass, hits the paddle of Miller. Nice job just keeping it there. The outside of the post, glove down here by Odeline, not able to get a clean clearance. Centering pass comes all the way across, and Motors able to clear it out of the zone for the Hogs. 15-12 to go, second period. On the puck now are the Patriots. Near side boards in their own zone. Bratton trying to clear the puck and does. Arkansas on it in the neutral zone. A battle for it on the near side boards in the neutral zone. Scrum for the puck. Arkansas after it here. Motor can't quite get on it, and is finally sent down into the zone by Crawford. All the way down, no icing here. Odeline makes a pass across to his D partner, and that's LaPlante. LaPlante lifts one towards center ice. It's stick down there by Bratton. Bratton on the puck in his own zone. Sends one hard around up to Smith, who absorbs a big check there by LaPlante. And those two trade cross checks. Ref not looking. Shot towards net, and that one is saved.
We got LaPlante and Smith getting into it right at center ice. And they're going to skate them to their benches rather than the penalty box.
I don't know why.
Well, I think the referee was ahead watching the puck, and the linesman was back with the two players who were really throwing punches. So looks like we'll stay 5-on-5. No harm, no foul.
Two guys, throwing haymakers at each other down here. It's kind of a tight angle. It was hard to see up against these boards, but LaPlante laid a hit on Smith, and he took exception to it, turned around, gave him a quick cross-check to the chest, and then LaPlante answered with one to the face. No calls on either of them. As Arkansas sends this one high, end over end, and after it here is Estrada. He's the first to the puck, but Miller beats him to it. Now Wilson on it. Man blows a tire. In front, Sugasawara scores! Answering the bell is Griffin Sugasawara. .425 to go in the second, and Arkansas extends the lead once again, and it's 3-1 Arkansas.
And a good play by Zach Wilson, picks up the puck on the near side boards, able to find the tape of Griffin Sugasawara right out in front. He buries it in the back of the net, and it looks like Arkansas is going to get a penalty for something that happened right after the goal was scored, as Deskier is in the box with 2 minutes up on the board.
I think there was a little cross check behind the play. Looked like after the puck was in the net, 21, who was that? Fabian Perez spilled to the ice, and it looked like it might have been a cross check on Deskier entering the zone well after the puck crossed the line.
So Arkansas gets the goal, but DBU is going to going to get the power play. And a good opportunity for them to try to get that goal back.
Face off one back by Arkansas. Yance on the puck now. Yance behind the net, stopping move there. Trying to hold on to the puck. Barrett behind the net, trying to dig it out of there. Near side boards, Blakely. Arkansas picking at it there, and they finally dig it out. That's going to be Yance. Back pass, finds his man, and Ellis can kill off some time. Ellis takes his time and sends it all the way down, high, all the way to the glass behind Randy Miller. Minute and a half to go on the Deskier minor penalty. A rare penalty from Jordan Deskier. It'll be his 18th penalty minute for the defenseman, and Arkansas covered up there. Haynes, yeah, just play that one with your stick. I think Haynes got a little excited there, put his whole glove over top of it, tried to sweep it out, but that was enough for the referee to blow the whistle.
Yeah, he's covered up quite a few quickly earlier in this game, so I think the referee expected that he was going to keep it.
Well, Arkansas, I think, doesn't mind a quicker whistle, as this one's shot towards the net. It's picked up here by Ellis. Ellis going to lift one down towards goal again, high of the net. Rattling around to the near side boards, picked up by Hamilton, far side now. Held in here by Hunter Miller, far side. Miller, outlet pass, is skated aside there by Ellis. He battles for it there at center ice. The puck comes chopping along. Finally picked up by McAtee with room to skate to the high slot. Has a back checker, throws the shot, saved by Miller. Picked up behind the net now. That's going to be Fortner, near side. Has Smith. Avery Smith into the offensive zone for DBU. He'll lift this one over the Razorback netminder. This one sent back ahead. Cruz chopping at it, lost control of it. Now a little drop pass, finds Bratton. Bratton circles one into the zone. Smith gets pinned there by LaPlante. Those two went at it earlier. As this one's lifted high into the air, back to center ice, comes rattling along down towards the goaltender. Quick play there by Miller. The way that went off. Finally laid off for Smith into the offensive zone. Smith looking for a man, streaking back post, shot saved. Nice pad save there by Haynes, and he's able to cover it up. Boy, he had to extend the leg to make that save.
Good initial save, but he was left scrambling, trying to get that rebound. Luckily, Cameron McAtee was there to help him clean it up rather than a DBU skater. As you see Haynes jump on top of that puck with 17 seconds remaining on the Deskier minor penalty.
Faceoff one back here by Arkansas. Bome tripped up a man on the faceoff, two DBU players down. They finally get to their legs. That was Barrett and Beckett. Two guys I regularly mix up. Back the other way, this is Canavan. Into the zone, sends one along. This is gonna be Odeline. Odeline along the boards, and the power play is over for the Patriots. Arkansas has a man ahead, looking to send one down the ice, and instead doesn't quite find share until late. And DBU is able to get back on the play. A big hit laid on by Odeline right in front of the referee. That was clean. Here comes Odeline. Back pass had Bome streaking to the net. Stolen away nicely on the back check by Barrett. Back the other way. Now Garcia. Garcia has Barrett with him, and Beckett back post. Shot saved by Haynes. Down below the goal line. Now picked up here by Garcia. Far side now. Canavan able to settle it down. Finds a man. A shot whiffed on there by a Patriot player. As this one shot towards the net. Tipped in front. Trying to skate it along there. And a little bit of carnage in front of the net, but Haynes makes the saves.
Yeah, a little tip in front. Haynes had to readjust himself as that puck was tipped. It did slow it down a bit, but had to try to kick that right pad out to make the save and able to jump on top of the puck. And had a dog pile on top of him for a few moments, but everybody appears to be okay.
Scherer to take the ensuing faceoff against Barrett. This one's one back, and Arkansas steals it away, though. Right off the win, here comes Valentini into the offensive zone. Tries a centering pass, nobody home for Arkansas, holding the line nicely as Romero's shot through traffic. Couldn't find Yassine. Yance pinching up, down to Yassine, fields it cleanly, centering pass, missed the stick of Valentini. Skated along now by Romero. Romero just dumps it back into the zone, and Arkansas gives chase again. Couple of hogs down into the corner. Canavan able to circle around his man there. Valentini loses control of the puck, far side. Big hit laid on there by Yance, and now Romero's on the puck again. Romero checks his man to the ice. Romero, nice job staying on top of the puck. Has Valentini streaking towards the zone. Romero still on it. Romero throws one back behind the cage. Miller watches it come out the near side. Now back the other way comes Hill. Austin Hill with a head of steam. Has to avoid the check from Scherer. A delayed offside here. Patriots have to check it up. I guess not. Beckett was waiting for it in the zone. Now Barrett after it. Barrett back to Beckett. Beckett below the goal line. Delayed penalty. Back to the point now. Garcia holding it in. Fires a shot through traffic. Saved down, and Arkansas touches it up.
Now that's going to be a hooking call. Looks like it may be Romero. It's actually going to be Yassine heading to the box, and DBU will once again go on the power play. And I talked about it earlier in the game, how important this faceoff is for DBU as they're able to get control of that faceoff. They really get some good offensive zone control, but after they lose the puck, they really don't have many opportunities to get it back.
Faceoff one back, now back to the point, has his man there, loads up a shot, tipped in front there by Deskier, able to get it wide of the net. Now Wilson on the puck, looking to backhand one along. Here comes McAtee on the forecheck. He has Sugasawara back post. Stick handling move and scores. A highlight reel goal from Griffin Sugasawara on the shorthand. And Arkansas takes a 4-1 lead.
Arkansas is lethal shorthanded, especially when you get Cameron McAtee and Griffin Sugasawara on a 2-on-1. Nice through pass and just an easy deke move. Effortless move for Sugasawara. Had Randy Miller flailing to the right, took him to the left of the backhand, and buries it in the back of the net. His second goal of the day and the fourth for Arkansas.
Ensuing faceoff one here by DBU. On the puck now is going to be Smith. Smith gets knocked off of it there, but back the other way comes Bratton, who gets leveled by Sugasawara. Lost his stick in the process, sent back down the ice. Sugasawara still on the forecheck. Arkansas still shorthanded. Back behind the net now, Hunter Miller. Miller, near side, has his man Hamilton. DBU needs to regroup. They are making a couple of mistakes here on this power play. Now back behind the net, Fortner back to the point. Has a man, that's going to be Miller. Miller gets a run at him there from Wilson. Back below the goal line now, centering pass back up top, has a man, Bratton. Bratton shot through traffic, goes wide. Losing the stick this time is Sugasawara. He's going to have to retreat for it, and Arkansas is on the breakout. Wilson on the ice, McAtee out there as well. Little back pass has Sugasawara, a little between the legs deep, stopping move now. Here's Sugasawara, back to the point. McAtee's shot on the one-timer is stopped down. Now McAtee will dump it back into the zone, and Arkansas gets the full change-off. McAtee the last one out there, actually. Got three guys on, though. Ellis, Cruz, and LaPlante to kill off this penalty. 30 seconds to go on the minor penalty to Yassine. Onto the ice. Cruz, a hard move towards the net. This one's chipped up in front and gloved down by Canavan. Canavan, a stopping move, goes back the other way. Finds his man out the other side, Hamilton. Hamilton looking for the inlet pass, skates it in himself. Throws one towards net. Kick save there by Haynes. Rebound out front. Shot blocked down in front by LaPlante, and Arkansas is able to get it aside. Sent back down the ice. 8 seconds to go shorthanded. Cruz on the forecheck. Has Ellis on the near side to watch anything coming out of the zone this way. Penalty finally expires. 8:38 to go in the second period. Patriots on the puck. Near side now, and they'll dump it all the way down the ice, and Arkansas will have an offensive zone faceoff with a tired power play unit out there. What a shorthanded job by Arkansas on the penalty kill, and get a goal and have the better opportunities, and the Patriots had no answer.
That's Sugasawara with a shorthanded goal.
Face off one back here. DBU up the near side boards as LaPlante finishes his check pretty hard. And LaPlante's gonna go to the box. Centering pass out front. This one comes all the way back out, and Arkansas does touch it up. Kevin LaPlante to the box. You know, he's already about 30 penalty minutes clear of the all-time record at Arkansas. And he might be the first Arkansas player to notch 200 in his career.
That's quite a feat. Only guy to take a skate off trying to stab somebody.
Well, he did play D1 as well, and those stats aren't even counted towards that, so he is well over 200.
So another power play for DBU, unsuccessful on the last one as Arkansas did have the shorthanded goal and some good physical play as well from Griffin Sugasawara, and they'll have to do it again here for another 2 minutes.
I think Arkansas taking a timeout. Nope, DBU taking the timeout. I think they just want to regroup. They had their first power play unit out there, basically that whole power play on the prior power play, the Yassine minor penalty, and now I think they just want to give them a quick breather so that they can have their best unit out there. They run these guys a lot, though. This Garcia, Barrett, Beckett line.
Yeah, I like this timeout here too because you're getting power play after power play, and really this game's not over yet. We got 8:15 left here in the second, as well as an entire third period to play, and they're only trailing by 3 goals. There's a lot of time left. If they could try to capitalize on this power play and cut into that lead, they could really keep this game close and try to take the wind out of the sails of Arkansas, who seem to just be cruising right now.
Well, Griffin Sugasawar is certainly cruising. He's 1 goal shy of a hat trick. It's really unfortunate that this net's in the way. Can't quite get your hat over top of that unless you really frisbee it over there.
I'll throw my headset over.
Get a little hammer throw, maybe. Might be able to make it over.
I don't know. I think the hat that Coach Val was wearing last night,
an excellent
might have
hat.
Some good glide to it.
Absolutely. That goes on the highlight reel at the end of the season. That thing was majestic.
They're giving DBU a whole lot longer than 60 seconds, I think, but that's all right. They look ready to go now.
They'll skate out to take the faceoff. It's going to be Barrett to take it against Scherer. Jake Scherer in the faceoff circle for Arkansas, the left-handed stick against the right-handed stick. This one's won back here by Barrett. Has a man at the point, sent back along into the corner. It's going to be picked up there by Hill. Hill loses control of it, and Arkansas sends it all the way down. Flat on the ice as the puck comes rattling around to Miller. A couple Arkansas players banging the glass. As McAtee stops the rush at center ice, McAtee still on it, and he's going to skate it out. 1:37 to go on LaPlante's minor. McAtee all the way back behind his own cage. Below the goal line, sends it trickling down the ice. Stopped there easily by Miller. He'll lay it off for Canavan. Canavan back behind his own cage now in the DBU zone. The Patriots with the puck skating left or right, wearing the blue uniforms. Arkansas in their white uniforms as Scherer comes away with it. Scherer on the puck again. Has a stopping move right by the bench as this one comes back out to center ice. McAtee back pass, has his man in Odeline. You know what he's going to do with it. He'll send one back over to McAtee, who sends it down the ice. 1:01 to go in the LaPlante minor penalty. Believe for roughing. Olme back behind the net now. It's laid off here for Ledbetter. Ledbetter, outlet pass, missed his man. Hill not able to stick it down. Smith giving chase now as Odeline chips a pass back across, finds McAtee. McAtee loads one up and slaps it back to the blue line. That's going to come all the way down. Miller's got to be quick with this one. Settles it down. Sends it easily to the near side boards as Arkansas is on a change. Back to the near side. Smith through traffic. Gets sticked off the puck momentarily by Valentini. Still on it though is Smith. Smith, a power move to the net. Fires it off the post. Net comes off its moorings. This one banked all the way down. No icing here. Trying to fix the net now is Haynes. They don't stop the puck play. Back the other way. This is going to be Fortner. Fortner on the puck. Near side has a man. That's going to be Smith. Smith, outlet pass, finds Bratton. Bratton lifts one into the zone. Takes an awkward bounce and just going to settle that one down as Haynes.
Yeah, just 9 seconds remaining on the power play for DBU. Definitely not what they were looking for coming out of that timeout with a full 2 minutes of a power play. It's been all Arkansas, controlling the puck, sending it down the ice, getting the puck back, sending it down the ice. Really frustrating, this Patriots team.
Another faceoff one. Here comes Trevor McClain. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Onside, throws one towards net and scores! Trevor McClain, shorthanded. And we've been waiting on that all season long. McClain notches his fourth of the season, and the Prosper Texas native able to put Arkansas up 5-1.
What a shot by Trevor McClain. Just a quick faceoff win, and he's able to skate it forward, throws the puck at the net, and just beats him high, and that's going to lead to a goaltender change as we're going to see Robert Beimers coming in for his first action of the weekend. 5 goals given up for Randy Miller.
Randy Miller played excellently this weekend, but after 93 minutes of action, 45 seconds, he'll finally come off the ice. So, yeah, we will see a new goaltender. Robert Beimers will get you his stats here in a moment as Deskier has the puck in the defensive zone. This is going to be Valentini. Valentini back pass has Deskier. Deskier stands his man up. Sugasawara giving chase in the corner. Has Ledbetter in his hip pocket. Comes back to the point. Stick handling there. It's going to be picked up by Perez. He gets upended there by Valentini, and Arkansas takes it out the other way. Valentini to Sugasawara. Man streaking behind. Sugasawara for the hat trick. Rebound there. It's up in the air, and a nice kick save by Miller. I think he got the leg up and got the skate on the puck just in time. Far side of the ice. Deskier not able to handle that one. Blakely after him there. Blakely able to clear it all the way down. That's going to go for an icing. Yachts, the first one to it. Robert Beimers from Alexandria, Minnesota. I just said Randy Miller on that play after the goaltender change, but Beimers 1-3 on the season, 3.54 goals against average, 900 save percentage, and it doesn't get any better than the one he just made.
Yeah, nice scrambling save as Sugasawara was looking for the hat trick, unable to do so, and then Beimers able to make a save on the second chance opportunity as well, having to get to work early here.
Two really good saves. I mean, Sugasawara has a massive wrist shot. He almost put one by him on the first one, almost got it by him on the second one. Then the rebound came out front, and he made a spectacular third save. Another shot through traffic, saved aside there by Beimers. Motor on the puck, back below the goal line. Backhanded along, that's going to be Canavan. Canavan to the far side, lifts one into the air, and after the puck there is going to be Barrett. Barrett's the first one to it. He comes charging in after Haynes. Haynes able to steer it aside. Arkansas still on it. 2-on-1 into the zone. This is Motor. Motor has Borlas with him. Nice little pass across, and Borlas scores! Tucks it in just past the skate of Beimers, and Arkansas takes a 6-1 lead. Got to be an early evening for these Arkansas Razorbacks as they take the 5-goal lead.
Wow, I did not know that Borlas had hands like that. An excellent little play as they get the puck on his stick and he's able to make a little deke move and just sneaks it past the right skate of Beimers.
Third goal of the season for Trevor Borlas, the sophomore from Negaunee, Michigan. Another kick save there by Haynes. Back into the zone, right back on the attack are Christian Beckett and the Patriots. Out of the zone, this one's tipped high towards the blue line, now picked up here by Bratton. He'll stick that one ahead and picked up here by Odeline. Back and forth now as Borlas comes away with the puck. Little backhand pass into the zone. Here comes Patterson. This line's been good all weekend. And here's Patterson trying to tuck it home. A glove save right out of the air by Robert Beimers. And the freshman, a lot of work already, and he's already made a couple of nice saves.
I know we said it earlier today, but Patterson has been hustling hard all weekend and almost gets a goal for it there. Good play.
He looks like a different skater out there right now.
Yeah, he sure does.
Kind of reminds me of Gratisar with that number. Skating around out there. This one's rattled around into the corner, near side now. It's going to be picked up here by Hamilton. Hamilton just sticks it back towards the blue line. Arkansas shoves it back into the zone. Bratton, center ice, Odeline, fields it there for Arkansas, dumped into the zone. Far side, Bratton. Bratton loses control of the puck. Wilson after it there. Wilson, Estrada, Sugasawara on the ice for Arkansas. Fortner able to shove it out of the zone, but good job by Sugasawara on the back check. He's going to get loaded up there by Smith, and Sugasawara gets the better of him again. LaPlante with a little extra after the play, and he's going to go to the box. Smith got upended after he tried to lay a hit on Sugasawara, and LaPlante gave him a little extra shove.
That was a big collision with Sugasawara that knocked him to the ground, and as he stood back up, LaPlante was standing right there, gave him a little bump. Definitely a lot less force than Sugasawara laid on, but LaPlante's hit sent him to the ground, and we'll send Kevin to the penalty box once again.
Somewhere near 10 penalty minutes this weekend alone. It put him around 80 for the season. Down low now, a quick shot there is going to be blockered aside. My goodness, a lot of steam on that one from Dylan Hamilton. Up into the air, Bratton after it now. Bratton has Fortner on the near side. He opts to pass it to him, just missed his stick, and out of the zone comes Hamilton. Arkansas steals it away, and here comes Wilson. Wilson with a head of steam, has one man to beat, and that's Bratton. He gets it to the back post, shoots and scores! Zach Wilson touches the ice, and Arkansas touches 7 on the board.
Just a turnover at the blue line by DBU and individual effort by Zach Wilson. Beats his man around the puck and Beimers sliding, trying to get to it, but good patience by Wilson. Just a power move here and then the patience to wait and then finally beats the sprawling Beimers and Arkansas puts up magic number 7.
Arkansas up a touchdown now. This one sent back. It's going to be picked up here. Bank pass along. Finds Hill. Hill into the offensive zone. DBU seeming to win the ensuing faceoffs, but turning it right over every time as they enter the offensive zone, and that allows for Odeline to send it down the ice. No icing, obviously. Man in the box. Got the linesman confused there as well. So we all do it as I exonerate myself from my earlier error. 1:05 to go. LaPlante in the penalty box. McAtee on the puck around the curling dot below his own goal line. Now he looks to skate it out himself. Here comes McAtee around two men into the neutral zone. Makes a head fake into the offensive zone. McAtee throws a shot towards net and a nice save made there by Beimers. Well, Beimers coming into a tough situation in Arkansas. Wants to test goaltenders. We've seen this before where a team makes a goaltender change and immediately Arkansas wants to
Just pepper him with shots, see what he's got, see if he's warm.
And it's certainly hard to stay warm when you're sitting over there for 30-plus minutes, and then the next thing you know, you're called upon. You got to come out and be ready, and he was initially, but Arkansas still able to notch a few goals, a couple of goals so far against the new goaltender. McClain on the puck, sends it back towards the blue line, stop down, shot in front, rebound there, and nobody home. Odeline able to calmly get it out of danger. Sends it down the ice. Two Arkansas players rushing to the puck. This is McClain, centering pass out front, out of the air. Valentini couldn't bat it. Tried to baseball one in.
Good shorthanded play there from Arkansas. Odeline sends it all the way down the ice. Valentini waiting in front, but that puck was tipped up in the air, and he plays hockey, not baseball, and we can see why.
Struck out swinging. 2:08 to go here in the second period. 16 seconds left in the power play to Kevin LaPlante. Ellis to take the ensuing faceoff to the right of Beimers. Arkansas wins this one back, all the way back to the point to Skier. Skier loads up another shot, stick to side by Beimers, near side boards. On the puck now is Bevers. Bevers loses the puck to Ellis momentarily, and out of the zone comes Ledbetter. Ledbetter powering past Cruz, but Cruz able to get the puck and send it to the far side. Out of the box now is LaPlante. He'll skate right back to his defensive spot and now head towards the bench. Skating slowly towards the bench is LaPlante. Onto the ice now, that's Cruz. Cruz gets sticked off the puck there. It's going to be picked up in the corner by Miller. That's Jackson Miller. A couple of guys after it now as Arkansas tries to keep the forecheck on, and here comes Cruz. Cruz has Jackson Miller on him. Miller stick checking Cruz, and the bigger Jackson Miller able to knock him off the puck. Back to the blue line and out of the zone. Arkansas not able to hold it down. So there's a penalty behind the play. And they're going to take Jackson Miller to the box.
A good physical play in the corner, but he just continued it after the puck had left the area.
Now Cruz is one of those high motor guys. Arkansas has got a few of those guys that just have a terribly high motor, and they will beat you any way they can. And Cruz, definitely one of those guys that chops his feet on the ice, keeps him moving, and creates a lot of plays and a lot of penalties because of it.
Arkansas with a man advantage and a six-goal lead.
Faceoff one back here by Ellis. Taps it back to the point. McAtee loads up a pass far side. Now Sugasawara. Sugasawara down low has his man Estrada. Estrada trying to dunk one home. Couldn't quite do it as it goes through the blue paint. Near side now Ellis on the puck. Ellis looking for his man. Back pass finds Wilson near side boards. Wilson back to the high point now along the blue line far side. Skated down there by Estrada. Turning move to the outer hash. Estrada on the puck now has McAtee at the point. Has a man on the back post. Ops for him. Shot off the post. Ellis whistled one by. This one comes back down around into the corner. Comes rattling along. Arkansas still on it. Have a back pass into the corner if they want it. Opt for the point instead. Wilson trades off here for McAtee. Near side point. 43 seconds to go in the period. Near side now Ellis. Ellis toe drag move. Shot saved there by Beimers. Far side now Estrada. Below the goal line. Arkansas on the puck still. Far side now it's going to be McAtee at the point. McAtee chip pass along. Spank back along there by Arkansas. Estrada finds the puck. Has Ellis. Has Wilson in front. Tipped in front. Comes all the way down to Wilson in the corner. Back to the point now. McAtee near side boards. McAtee head fake there. Loads one up far side, little wheeling shot there by Estrada, not able to get it off. He's on his backhand now, has to avoid two defenders. 13 seconds to go in the period. Shot saved by Beimers. Back down into the corner. 9 seconds to go in the period. Again, another chip pass down low. Sugasawara back post, wrong stick for Wilson. 4 seconds to go in the period. Centering pass, McAtee couldn't handle it, and that's going to expire the period. Arkansas goes into the break with a 7-1 lead.
Good, exciting power play at the end of that period from Arkansas. Excellent puck movement. I really like seeing Estrada out there. Really good with a puck on a stick and a good compliment to McAtee at the blue line. And then some nice plays down below the goal line with Sugasawara as well, trying to find Wilson out in front. And just Arkansas unable to score on that power play, but really poured it on in that second period, putting up five goals to extend this lead to 7-1 as we head into the second intermission.
Well, let's not forget Austin Hill did notch one, and I think it got a lot of pep in this Arkansas step. Arkansas was up 2-0 when Austin Hill knocked one into the back of the net, and then it was met with a flurry of goals from Arkansas, two by Sugasawara and one by, I believe it was,
Borlas.
One by Borlas and one by McClain, I believe.
McClain, yeah, the shorthanded from McClain.
Anyways, a plethora of goals there for Arkansas to close the period. Five straight, and Arkansas has asserted their dominance in this game. I think they just needed to be scored on to pick up the pace a little bit. Once they realized it was a one-goal game, they really turned it on. But don't go anywhere. We'll be back in about 12 minutes for the start of the third period. Your Arkansas Razorbacks lead by a score of 7-1. Welcome back to the Jolt Center here in Springdale, Arkansas, alongside Matt Martens, Loren McClain, and Corry Porter. My name's EJ Sanders. Arkansas, a flurry of goals to end that period, 5 to be exact. And my goodness, they really put the onslaught on after DBU was able to notch one of their own. They got a goal from Austin Hill. Houston, Texas made it a 2-1 game, but from there, Griffin Sugasawara able to get on the board twice. Trevor McClain, a goal of his own, and Trevor Borlas as well, before closing out the period with the Zach Wilson goal.
Yeah, a couple shorthanded goals from Arkansas. Sugasawara had one, and Wilson's was shorthanded as well, as DBU did make a goaltender change after the fifth goal was given up. And they put Robert Beimers, the freshman, in net, and he gave up a couple goals, made some nice saves early, but, man, when you're coming off the bench against a team that's rolling like Arkansas is right now, it's tough going, so hopefully he got his wits about him in the locker room and comes out for this third period ready to go. You know Arkansas is going to be ready to go, and they will start this period on the power play.
Yeah, only about 17 seconds left on that. Center ice faceoff is going to be taken by Jake Scherer for Arkansas. They got Cruz, Scherer, and Valentini on the ice along with Odeline. It looks like Ethan Motor. On the other side, it's going to be Beckett to take the faceoff. He's on the ice along with Dylan Hamilton, John Canavan, and playing defense right now, Hunter Miller. Feels like Miller's been playing in that defensive spot. I'm not certain if he's been transitioned there. He's listed as a forward on the roster. Might be a similar situation to Chris Yontz for Arkansas. Converted forward to D.
Could be a typo.
I could have just misinput the information. Back the other way, Odeline into the zone. Arkansas right off the bat trying to put some pressure on. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Misinformed on how much time was going to be left on that. So it's sent back down the ice. So Arkansas with a little bit of time to work here. Haynes on the puck, paddles it down, leaves it there for Motor. Motor, turning move back behind the net, leaves it here for Odeline. Arkansas on the flying V, sends one near side, finds a Motor. Motor up the near side, boards, gets turned away. Odeline on the puck, 10 seconds to go in the power play. 30 seconds gone here in the period. That one hit the stick pretty hard of Valentini, and that will kill off the rest of this penalty. 7-1, Arkansas leads. Motor on the puck, sends one to the near side. Boy, just can't get a clean pass across. Hard off the boards, gloved down by McAtee to the high circle. Chips a pass along, rebound on the back post. How about that pass from Scherer to Valentini? And Nick Valentini notches his fifth of the season. What a one-touch pass from Jake Scherer.
Yeah, good passing from Arkansas. Starts at the point with McAtee. Just a little backhand pass down to Scherer and a touch pass to Valentini. Just sitting right in front, unable to be tied up. Barrett was there, but Valentini able to get his stick free and gets one of the easier goals of his career as the excellent passing sets him up. McAtee and Scherer on the assists. Valentini with Arkansas's eighth goal of the afternoon.
Just like that, three touches, one goal, and Arkansas's up 8-1. As they tack on the extra point. Send down into the zone. Now it's going to be picked up in the corner. After it there are the Patriots, turned away at the blue line again. Arkansas doing a lot with what they did in the third period yesterday, only with more goals, as this one's out front again. Sugasawara's shot's turned away there by Beimers. Another opportunity, a centering pass. One-timer scored. Beimers not able to handle that one. A little pass from Zach Wilson to Sugasawara, and Sugasawara has another hat trick.
Yeah, Wilson just settles it down there. Sugasawara drifts away from the crease and able to put that in the back of the net. As you mentioned, his third goal of the afternoon for the hat trick. Arkansas leads this one 9-1.
Three goals for Griffin today. Just a standard day at the ice for Griffin Sugasawara as he notches three more, inching his way towards the 100 career goal mark for Arkansas. Another tough angled shot. And that one finds its way through. Another goal. Tough angle. And Beimers just couldn't handle it. Off his shoulder into the net. Cam McAtee makes it 9-10-1. Losing track.
Let's take another look at that one. As McAtee picks it up at the red line, he's able to skate in.
Oh, man.
Just a sharp angled shot.
negative. It looked like he shut it down.
I think Vimers thought he had it. It must have just hit the outside of his arm instead of the inside and just trickled into the back of the net, and McAtee with a goal.
10-1, and Arkansas can just skate out the last 18 and a half. Boy, they really turned it on here late. Eight straight goals after the quick answer by Austin Hill in the second period. Looked like we were going to have ourselves a game. Suwara got two quick ones, and just like that, Arkansas took off. Another low shot. Beimer steers it to the corner. Beimer's the freshman. He's going to have plenty of time to learn from this game as well, as this one shot down towards Estrada. Back down to the point, and Arkansas on the puck again. Sugasawara shot down into the zone. Sugasawara on the puck again. Probably won't see too much of this line for the rest of the period, and just offside is Deskier. Couldn't quite get back. Had to fight his way through some DBU line change traffic over there. 17:42 to go, third period. Arkansas has notched three already in this period.
Yeah, back in the second period, DBU was trailing 4-1. Had a power play about to start, took a timeout to talk it over. And since then, Arkansas scored six straight goals, eight straight overall.
Timeout almost helped Arkansas as much. Odeline gloves that one down, back to center ice. This one comes free, and it's picked up here by Miller. Hunter Miller, far side now, dumped into the zone. Jantz giving chase. Left-handed stick, backhanded pass, wheeled back along, finds Cruz. Cruz looking to break out of the zone as he digs it off the boards. Far side of the ice, tipped in here by McClain, and over the glass and out of play. 17-18 to go. Been a frustrating road trip here for DBU. Last night, putting up a pretty good fight. Had some excellent goaltending behind them, and it seemed like they came out to play for Randy Miller. Only conceding three goals, but not able to notch one of their own as Joseph Dusanka turned on his Dominic Hasek impression and got the shutout. Jantz to Odeline. And he'll turn this one over to the high slot. Another shot towards net. Haynes just sees that one wide. Back to the point now. Miller's shot's blocked down. Ellis after it there. Now McClain on the puck. Just backhands one along. Ellis after it there. Good job by Beimers just to get a glove on top of it. Like we said, coming out cold is tough to do as a goaltender. And I think the break didn't help at all either. After conceding a couple of goals, looked pretty sharp towards the end of the period. A flurry of shots Arkansas put on. And then here early in the period, it's just gotten away from DBU. A drive-by face-off there as Patterson was still skating to the circle as the puck was dropped. Picked up here by DBU in the corner. Borlas after it. A goal scorer tonight for Borlas. Nice to see him on the scoreboard. Only his third of the season. And that depth scoring has come through for Arkansas all weekend long. But it really took that top line getting going. Sugasawara and Wilson had four of the goals today, accounted for that many. Behind the net now, into the corner. Motor back along, finds Borlas in the corner below the goal line to the outer hash. 10-1, Arkansas leads, 3 minutes, 46 seconds gone. All the way down for an icing. Seems like DBU's relenting a little bit here. I think both teams now are pretty sure of the outcome of this game. DBU wants to probably skate a good showing here, though.
Yeah, just trying to get past Cam McAtee, who was holding his spot at the blue line and pushed it a little bit too far ahead.
He's a tough guy to beat back there. McAtee at the point, stick handling. Throws one towards net, tipped in front. Nice save by Beimers. High into the air, fluttering over top. Romero pinching up on the play, and back the other direction comes Avery Smith. He almost gets upended there, but a centering pass finds Fortner. Shot saved there by Haynes, and Fortner gets upended. Picked up now by Smith. Shot towards net. Haynes makes two saves. Going to be picked up near side. Romero lays another hit on Canavan. It's finally picked up, and they're going to have a delayed penalty. Not certain who's going to go to the box.
I think it's Borlas. I don't know if they're going to call a trip or an interference, but he took a man down. I think that was Fortner. And Fortner actually slashed him in the leg in retaliation. I don't know if they're going to get Fortner for that as well. Doesn't look like they will, but Borlas will go to the box. And Arkansas will go on the penalty kill once again. They do have two shorthanded goals so far today.
I'd be surprised if they go with Sugasawara and Wilson any more than they have to for the rest of this game. So they will go instead with Bome and Valentini. Valentini with a nice goal earlier. Wide open net, a great pass from Scher, but still got to put those in. The left-handed stick was able to tap it home. McAtee switching sides here with Yontz. Yontz, Bome, Valentini, and McAtee on the ice. And McAtee smartly just knocks it down the ice. 15:36 to go, third period. Out of his net to play it there is Bimers. On the puck now, near side. It's going to be Canavan. Canavan, stick handling, makes a turning move, looking for an outlet pass. Canavan across the red line, dumps it in, and they'll give chase. Yontz going to be the first one to the puck for Arkansas. He'll send this one down the ice. Comes rolling out. Bimers way out to play it. Turns it over in front of his own net. Thrown towards net. Nice save by Bimers. Comes diving back across. Not a save you want to make, but one you had to make after the turnover. Valentini. McAtee. Pass from Yontz. McAtee back behind his own net. 1:15 to go in the power play. This one sent all the way down on. Oh, my goodness, in the goal. Cam McAtee finds the five hole, and not a great shift for Robert Bimers.
Unfortunate. McAtee just icing it down, and Bimers tries to slow it up, and it just looks like it hit his stick and just beats him five hole. This was Bome's chance. I almost said Bome was the only player on the ice that doesn't have a goal this weekend, as McAtee, Yontz, and Valentini do have a goal, but Bome unable to score on that chance, and unfortunate for Bimers there as that one goes in from deep. And Arkansas's third shorthanded goal of the afternoon.
Now to play on the assumed faceoff. 14:44 to go. Fans, we appreciate your support of the broadcast. We had a couple of donations last night that we appreciate. If you would like to donate to the broadcast, everything we get in donations goes right back into the equipment we use. So if you're enjoying the stream and you would like to see it upgraded or improved upon, then feel free to hit that donation link. And any amount helps, of course. And we are more than thankful to be able to do this for going on 7 years now. For the Arkansas Razorbacks, started out as just a radio broadcast on Mixler, and now we have a full-blown YouTube channel, so it's nice to have a lot of support from parents and fans, and hope to continue that going forward. McAtee on the puck for Arkansas, red line, blue line, offensive zone, right-handed stick, going to fire one towards net, low through the legs, and oh, doesn't find its way by. A couple sticks went in the air in celebration, but a little premature. 22 seconds to go on the Borla's penalty, and Fortner just wants to settle it down. The captain back behind the net. Far side. Up the ice, here comes Garcia, one of the grad students for the team. They've got a few of them. Fortner and Garcia are two of them. As McAtee skates it along, he gets it turned over there. It comes back out front. Beckett not able to come away with the puck. Backhanded pass in front, stopped down by Odeline. Not able to clear it. Beckett on the puck again. Christian Beckett. Been held scoreless all weekend. Fires a shot. Blocked down by Odeline. Far side, Scherer. Five on five action as McClain skates it ahead. Just onside, Estrada. This one comes down into the zone. Arkansas gets their top line on the ice. Sugasawara, Estrada. Odeline steps up for a hit there on Beckett. He's able to absorb that and come away with the puck. Near side boards, a battle for it. Finally coming away with it under the Patriots, and here comes Ledbetter. Head of steam into the zone. Ledbetter, backhanded opportunity through the blue paint. Far side now, Sugasawara. He'll make a stopping move off a skate of Estrada back ahead. Romero's pass goes errant, and it finds the stick of Hamilton. Big hit late on by Romero. Odeline near side boards. Banks along, comes trickling down the ice into the defensive zone for DBU. 13 minutes to go in this game. Through pass looking for Ledbetter, comes all the way down, and they're going to blow it dead for an icing. Wilson the first to the puck. 12:47 to go. 11-1 Arkansas leads. One of the strangest, a couple of the strangest goals we've seen. And I think just getting beat on those two early chances, I think, is kind of hurt Robert's confidence in net here, Bimer's confidence.
Yeah, I think it's good experience for him, and he'll learn from it going forward.
Face-off one back here. And both of those were McAtee's goals that found their way by in just odd ways. An odd angled shot, nearly negative angle. That found its way in the back of the net off the back of Bimers.
Yeah, it's tough to come in cold off the bench against the number three team in the country. Coming off a national championship appearance. And you know, it could be a daunting experience. But like I said, he'll look to learn from it. And you know, improve going forward.
Well, he'll see a face-off to his left. Arkansas Fresh skaters on the ice, and this is Patterson's line. Patterson, Yassine, and Motor on the ice. Near side boards, McAtee pinching down. McAtee around the boards, finds Yassine far side. He'll field it there, chases after the puck. Backhands one along, smart play to the corner. Motor centering pass, Patterson in front. Strong move to the backside of the net. Back to the point, looking for McAtee. Loses the puck, though. McAtee stands a man up. Back the other way, here comes DBU. They're out of the zone, but Arkansas knocks it back to the neutral zone. Arkansas on the puck now, Patterson. Patterson chopping his feet into the zone. Sends one along after Motor, but Motor's not able to get to it as Jackson Miller's on the puck. Motor able to steer it back into the corner. Far side corner now in the Patriots zone. Arkansas on the puck again to Skier. A little backhand pass has a man out front. That's Yassine, who wasn't able to get to the puck, and he gets upended into the corner as Jackson Miller is leaving a lot of players in his wake, and down in the corners, Yassine.
A little pushing and shoving going on there as well. Yassine seems to be holding up in the collarbone area, maybe the shoulder.
Yeah, he's definitely holding his shoulder. Doubled over in pain, clearly.
I don't know if they're going to, and they are going to send a man off the ice.
Jackson Miller to the locker room. 0 goals, 0 assists, 0 points, 2 penalty minutes for Jackson Miller coming into the weekend. Has notched quite a few today. And that 10-minute misconduct will go on his record as well, along with the 4 penalty minutes he accrued, to bring his total to 16. Going back to the box is Loudon Harris, who has not seen the ice today, but has seen the penalty box twice.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration from DBU. They seem to always come in here and play tough no matter what, even in some of the big losses that they have had. They play tough to the final whistle. I'd expect nothing less here. Not gonna lay down and just let Arkansas coast to a victory. They're gonna come out and make them work for it and try to put some more goals up as well. And really need to try to keep the puck out of their own end and away from the goaltender, Bimers. Try not to hurt his confidence anymore.
Meanwhile, a great showing. We haven't gotten to talk about it enough, but Sam Haynes has been good down on this end of the ice, and I think the defensive effort, while not a clean sheet, is one you can be proud of if you're Coach Sims.
Yeah, for sure. Sam's had to make a few tough saves. Did give up the one goal to Hill, and he'll learn from that as well, but Arkansas really good defensively in front of him, stymieing a bunch of the DBU chances, trying to break into the zone especially.
Arkansas on the power play, Sukasawara outer hash on the ensuing faceoff, 1:50 to go in this power play. Backdoor pass, Wilson shot saved. Nice save there by Bimers.
Great pass there by Sukasawara too. Split the legs of a DBU defender right to the tape of Wilson. And a good save by Bimers.
Face off one back. It's going to be McAtee at the point. Has Estrada near side, opts for the shot, and that one goes up and out of play. Well, we will be off next weekend. Arkansas is on the road at Missouri State for a 2-game set. But we will be back the following weekend for another 2-game set, the final home series for Arkansas, at least in regular season play. We do have an exhibition scheduled, I believe, in March against Oklahoma State. Here at the Jones Center, just a little skate to get warmed up for Nationals. This is a team that's going to be going if they stay in this form, and Sugasawara is in form today, up the far side of the ice into the offensive zone. Sugasawara on the puck, a minute 14 to go here on the penalty. Sugasawara skating around the zone, still on the puck, high circle, far side, finds Wilson. Wilson stopping move, high circle on the far side of the ice, finds his man, that's Sugasawara in front, tipped in front, and Ellis not able to bury it. Held in the zone momentarily, but Wilson can't quite hold the line. Sugasawara off for a change. Into the zone, here comes Ellis. It's stolen away and back the other direction. Into the offensive zone comes Hamilton. Hamilton's shot, tried to pick the far side corner. Almost did, missed wide. Ellis on it again, right-handed stick. Has Valentini with him. Through pass, finds Valentini. Shot, glove save. Two there for Bimers. Arkansas on it again. Ellis after it. Just past the stick of McAtee. McAtee sees it down the ice. 33 seconds to go on the power play as we about cross the halfway point of this third period. Here comes McAtee. McAtee, offensive zone, flips it high into the far side corner. After it into the corner is going to be Garcia. Arkansas holds the line. Motor absorbs a hit there. Picked up by Valentini in the corner. Valentini tries to wheel it around to the near side. Has Estrada and McAtee on the puck. McAtee, backhand pass. He loses it. This one's going to be taken away. Skated up by Canavan. Canavan, far side of the ice, has McAtee in his hip pocket. And just offside. Ahead of the play was Austin Hill, the goal scorer for DBU.
Not the best effort to try to stay onside there. Dragged a leg a little bit, but...
It's easy to lose yourself on this ice out there. If you're used to skating on an extra 20 feet of neutral zone, it might be.
Yeah, that blue line comes up on you pretty quick. 4 seconds left on the power play.
Jackson Miller was off the ice. Serving that penalty is Loudon Harris. The Oklahoma City, Oklahoma native has a goal, 2 assists, 3 points on the season. And he will find his way back to the bench. Up ahead, Borlas giving chase, comes all the way down. No icing. Canavan first to the puck. Canavan, left-handed stick, backhanded pass up the wall, trying to pinch down from his D-spots. Yant sends it across. Now Borlas. Borlas, high circle, near side. Stick handling move through traffic. Borlas shot low, kick save. Bimers kicks it to the corner. Still Borlas on the puck. Tries to lay it off there for Patterson. Patterson on it now, along with Yants. Patterson, toe drag move, has Yants at the point. Nice little tic-tac play there. Thrown through traffic, tipped in front by Borlas, and smacked up out of play by Bimers. A little mutual respect tap there from Borlas and Bimers. And we have under 9 to play.
Nice play there from Yants. He looked for the first pass, looked for the second pass across to Romero. Saw both weren't there and just took the wrist shot instead. Got it on goal, but a good save by Bimers. Sends that one up and out of play.
Faceoff one back by Arkansas. Chip to the near side board. It's going to be fielded here cleanly by Beckett. Sends it down the ice. Giving chase here is Barrett. Yants the first one to it, though, for Arkansas. He gets stood up there by Barrett. Barrett chasing after the puck now. Now Patterson. Patterson, another toe drag move through traffic. A lot of carnage on the ice. That's Barrett on the ice. He finally gets back up. Yants, a little drop pass, stolen away here by the Patriots. Turned back by Beckett. Beckett gets upended. Knocking over McClain on the bench. As Romero's hit went right through him. Romero on the puck now. Below the goal line in his own zone. Lays one off for Yants, and Arkansas regroups. 5-on-5 action right now. Yants on the puck, has Borlas near side. Borlas cross center ice, sends one high into the air, down into the corner. Giving chase there is Patterson. Patterson locked up there with Canavan. Finally coming away with it are the Patriots. Now Patterson out front, fires a shot, saved down, rebound there, slapped towards the goal, but it steered to the near side corner. Hard around the boards, far side. Now Beckett not able to clear the zone. Odeline on it. Bank pass finds Motor. Motor, a little tic-tac pass, is broken up in front. The Patriots will work it out the other way. Finally clears the blue line back to the neutral zone, and Arkansas regroups. Near side boards now. Odeline on the puck for Arkansas. The Hogs looking to break out. Stolen away here by Beckett. Arkansas does take it away. Deskier takes a shot to the midsection. Back the other way comes Valentini. Loads up a shot, fired wide. Tried to pick the far side corner. Left-handed stick, not able to find it on the left side of the ice. Stick lift opportunity, not able to take the puck away. They do clear the offside. Scherer on it there, sends it back for Valentini. Valentini throws one towards the zone. No icing here as this one sent down, and Hunter Miller to field it. Hunter Miller, far side, has a man there, not able to clear the zone as Hamilton. Arkansas sees it trickle over 2 sticks, and back the other way comes Smith. Avery Smith, right-handed stick on the near side of the ice. Skating from right to left. DBU is from left to right, Arkansas, as another pass to the point comes rattling around, pinballing in front, and a snow angel there from Haynes, able to make the save.
Yeah, good tough save there. Just laying down on top of it. DBU desperately trying to get another goal in the back of the net, unable to do so there. There's no quitting this team, that's for sure.
We'll have to see it. DBU did go to Nationals as well last year. The Nationals appearance. Did not quite make it out of group play. They were in a tough group, though. Arkansas on the puck. Sent down the ice. Cruz is after. Cruz has a man in the middle. That's Ellis. Makes a stopping move instead below the goal line. Sends it back along. Hits the blue paint to the far side. Ellis, near side. Now Cruz on the puck. Cruz on the outer hash of the near side circle, dumps one back along, finds McClain. McClain takes a stick up high, no call. Here comes DBU back the other way. McAtee on it. Backhanded back into the zone. He gets stood up there by Smith, who's still throwing the body. Another hit back behind the net. Cruz able to get the puck off the man's stick. Ellis on it now, near side boards, offensive zone. McAtee through traffic. Nice save there. Comes bounding out, though. A lot of rebounds given up here as McClain throws one back towards net. Settled down here by Arturo Garcia. McClain tries to soccer one back along, back to the point. Has a man there. It's played back along by Yontz, near side. Now McAtee. McAtee throws a low shot through traffic. Stolen away. Ellis stands a man up. Goes to the far side. Cruz can't corral it. And back the other way comes Hamilton. One-on-one with the All-American. And guess who stymied the play? That's Cam McAtee all over the puck. And McAtee's showing you why. He keeps getting that first team nod. He's good on both ends of the ice. He's good just about everywhere. I'm sure if they made those charts that showed you like where guys are good and bad on the ice, you know, it would be all green for McAtee as he's got the puck up the far side into the high slot, drops a pass off. Patterson back door looking for McAtee. Borlas slaps one towards the net. Wide. Beaume on it. Loses control of the puck momentarily. Miller trying to come away with it, but Beaume does a good job of stopping the play. Beaume. A patient skater sends one back to the point. Skated down there by Odeline. Odeline leaves one along looking for Beaume. Beaume can't get the stick down quick enough, and he's got to chase after it. Near side now to Skier. Finds Patterson. That's offside. Didn't see Odeline deep in the zone. 4:53 to go. Third period of action. Again, we won't be back for another 2 weeks. I believe Arkansas closes the season with ETBU. Here at the Jones Center. That's when we'll close up our season, I'm sure, as well. Share to take the ensuing center ice faceoff. This one's one back. It's going to be played off here by Garcia. Garcia just flips that one out of play. Be a defensive zone faceoff now. Valentini having a talk with Garcia.
Take a look at the schedule for Arkansas.
Oh, it's Kansas that comes in.
Yep. That'll be a good game for the MACA playoffs and the national tournament.
Now Arkansas is all but assured the one seed for the MACA playoffs. The goal differential is great. The game against North Texas, the plus 16 will definitely help that out. Is this one stolen away and back up the ice into the offensive zone? On a breakaway is Christian Beckett. He fires a shot, saved by Haynes. Takes a shot from his own sliding defender, the 6'3", 205-pound Dylan Odeline. It's crashing in, but Sam Haynes.
Haynes made the initial save, and the puck kept trickling towards him, so I had to kick it again, and then Odeline came crashing in as he was trying to recover, nearly made a trip, and ended up tripping himself instead. Good job by Haynes to stay in front of that one.
Good job of keeping that pad right on the post. Almost hooked his skate on the post to keep his pad in place and made a nice save. Laid it right down on the ice. Here comes Scherer back the other way, centering pass, looking for Motor on the near side. Arkansas chips it along the boards, back behind the net. It's going to be picked up there by Miller. 11-1, Arkansas leads. It's been all Arkansas in the latter stages of this game. 9 straight goals by the Hogs. Motor, outlet pass, looking for Valentini. He'll just turn one into the zone. Stick down there by Beimers. He comes out of his net to play. Backhanded pass, banked along, far side now. Coming out to play that one is Hunter Miller. Hunter Miller, near side now. He's got a man. It's going to be Garcia. Garcia, across the blue line into the offensive zone. Fires a shot off a face mask and out of play. That's a way to use your head there, Sammy. 3:35 to go in the third. Boy, that cannot be a fun thing seeing.
Yeah, you really got to trust the equipment at that point. Yeah, he rose up to try to get that one, too.
I see people all the time flinch when a puck comes at the glass and they're standing right behind it. You can only imagine when it actually hits you in the face mask. Yontz on the puck, far side. Arkansas looking to break out of their own zone. Near side boards, off the boards. It's held in here by Avery Smith. He absorbs a hit from Romero. Avery still on the puck. Smith, centering pass off the side of the net. Fortner's shot. Doesn't quite find pay dirt. This shot whistled towards the net. Smith on it again. Backhanded opportunity. Trickles in front. A nice save again there by Haynes. A lot of traffic all of a sudden from DBU. You'd like to see more of that.
Yeah, good pressure here from the Patriots. Like I said, they don't quit. They definitely want to put more up on the board, even though they may not win the game, and they're making Sam Haynes work late in this game.
3:08 to go, third period. Patterson to take the faceoff. One back here to Yance. Yance on the puck. Stopping move. Has a man far side. Odeline. 3:03 to go in the period. Odeline. Backhand pass. Has Yance near side. Outlet pass now finds Patterson looking for a man ahead. And he does have him. Bome skating ahead but just lost control of the puck. Turn back behind the net. Bome centering pass looking for Borlas. Comes back out front. Patterson after it. Trickling in front. Doesn't find the net. Oh, it just went past the post. The net comes off its moorings. 2:44 to go in this game. And Patterson is going to be wishing he had that one back.
Good hustle from Bome. Looks for Borlas out in front, but it trickles out ahead to Patterson. Gets one shot away, a second shot, and he's trying to get it. It looked like DBU got a stick in there to keep him from scoring on that empty net, and it just trickles to the far side post before the net gets knocked off its moorings. And DBU saved a 12th goal from being put up there. And I said there's no quitting DBU. There's no quitting Arkansas either. They want to keep putting up goals and want to keep playing hard for the final 2:44.
I'm sure that's the message on the bench. Keller Sims not one to phone it in for the last few minutes of a game. Centering pass here from Patterson. Finds a man there. That was Borlas. Just got a stick lifted in front. Sent out by Blakely. Back to center ice. Settled down there by Deskier. Far side Patterson. Patterson on the ice with Odeline. Odeline, nice stick handling move through traffic as Bome is able to tip that one into the zone. Canavan hard skating after the puck with Borlas in his hip pocket. Far side, now that's Deskier. He sockers one along, finds Borlas. Borlas has Bome streaking to the net. Another nice stick lift there from Canavan. Canavan, near side boards, looking to break out Blakely. Blakely on the puck to Canavan, sends it back to neutral ice. 2 minutes to go here in this weekend. Arkansas has done everything but get the shutout today. Is Patterson able to stick handle in front? Arkansas still on the puck, offensive zone. Deskier, high point, leaves one here, has McAtee. Sorry, that's Yance. Yance down below the goal line now. It's pressured there by Ledbetter. Another centering pass to the back door. Puck comes free out front. Nice backhanded opportunity. And Chris Yance knocks it home. The Argyle, Texas native with two goals this weekend. And that'll triple his total on the season. Went from 1-3. And Yance, guy I talked with Coach Sims about before the game.
Just an individual effort from behind the net, able to get it out in front, and makes a nice second effort to put it in the back of the net.
Arkansas, a dozen goals here. To close out the weekend, they're going to try to make it a baker's dozen here shortly. Back the other way. Into the zone comes Scher. Gets turned away there by Barrett. Far side of the ice. Arkansas on the puck again. Yance, near side, now Romero. Romero, as Yance goes off the ice. Odeline. Deskier getting an assist on that one as Romero gets upended at center ice. Hard hit there by Austin Hill. Into the zone, shot there by Beckett. Not able to find the net. They've shut him down all weekend. Centering pass, finds a man out front. That's Barrett. 50 seconds to go in this game. Barrett on the puck. Turns it back towards net. Haynes able to shut it down, and Odeline settles it down. 43 seconds to go. And Arkansas drawing the applause. Skating hard after the puck still is Austin Hill. Boarding a hit there is Valentini as this one's soccered back along. Canavan turns it back to the neutral zone. Now Beckett on it. And they're going to get a bench minor. LaPlante going to go to the locker room. He's going to go the long way. Ten-minute misconduct here for LaPlante. Twenty-five seconds to go in this game.
Yeah, he's spent a lot of time in the box, and he's going to spend some time in the locker room now. Likes to talk, likes to jaw a little bit, and, you know, when you aim it at the ref, especially in a game like this, they're going to shut you down, so 2 minutes will be on the clock for that. And Arkansas will be, well, they do got five out on the ice. There we go. Motors going to the bench. Final 25 seconds. Arkansas should be shorthanded, barring a goal.
Quick shot there. Glove down by Haynes. 21 seconds. Boy, late stop there.
We're trying to get home in time to watch the Bengals beat the Titans.
Well, they're making up for the 7 seconds that they had extra yesterday.
Yeah. Ooh. As Barrett goes down to the ice, he's taking a few lumps today.
Well, he gets down to those dirty areas quite a bit.
Yeah, he took a shot from Borlas earlier in the game up under the chin and had to skate to the bench and threw a stick in frustration then, but he's been out on the ice since then, plenty.
Tie up there from Scherer. Wow, you don't see a whole lot of that at this level. A little tie up from Scherer. He's back to center ice. And Odeline will skate out the final 6 seconds of this game. He sends it all the way down, 4 seconds to go. They'll wave off the icing. And that will conclude the weekend. Arkansas wins by a score of 12-1.
Good win for the Hogs, and really what they were looking for yesterday. They came away with a 3-0 win last night, but came out a little bit flat. They did have a long break since early December, and it was their first game back, but really got back to form today, scoring in bunches, really pouring it on in that second period, and finish it out in the third. And a hat trick from Griffin Sugasawara, a couple for McAtee, and really just scoring all across the board with Yance, Wilson, Borlas, everybody getting involved, Valentini as well.
Yeah, it was good to see Arkansas come out, and I know Sims was not happy with the performance yesterday in spite of the shutout. Nice to have Dusenka back there, but having Haynes in goal, Arkansas, a similar performance. It seemed like right when DBU was acting like they were going to get back in this game, Arkansas said no, sir, and scored 10 unanswered goals to put away this DBU Patriots team. So Arkansas moves now to 21-2 on the season. Your number three Razorbacks getting set to go to the MACA tournament, and then after the MACA tournament, they will be headed to Nationals. DBU, meanwhile, they will fall to 9-12-3 on the season, and a little bit of regrouping to do before their next series. And hopefully this doesn't give them a lot of confidence. It's nice seeing another team, though, come in here and put up a fight against these Razorbacks, and one within their division as well. It's been a while since Arkansas has had a rival outside of Missouri State, and it feels like one is forming here against the Patriots.
Yeah, absolutely. They come in, they play tough every game, but Arkansas seems to have their number at this point, and you know, they're rolling. They'll roll into Missouri State next weekend and try to keep it going as they try to finish out this season strong.
All right. Well, that'll do it for us this weekend. The final score tonight, 12-1 Arkansas for Matt Martens, Loren McClain, Corry Porter. My name's EJ Sanders. So long from the Jones Center.